Whoa! F***ing hell! Good morning everybody, welcome to my channel. I am Luke and this is Luke CMHTV. Thanks for watching. Thank you for tuning in. We are on our way to Reading, and why does he have flashing lights on up ahead? Oh God. Everyone's flashing their headlights, their hazard lights over there. Caution, queue. Oh. Looks like we're in a bit of a traffic jam. Just a tiny bit. Whoa! Fucking hell! No way! Oh shit! Fucking hell. We're on our way to Reading. My TomTom's got live traffic updates, and it's just updated, and apparently there's an hour and 29 minutes worth of queuing. Seven miles remaining. Surely it would take an hour and a half to do 7 miles. That's what the sat nav's saying. The time now is 8:10. It takes an hour to get to Reading. I've already been driving for 50 minutes. But I've had to go get loaded as well. I was going to say, that doesn't make sense. I've been driving for about maybe 25 minutes. So I should only really have half an hour's, maybe 45 tops left to do. It's saying it's going to take an hour and 52 minutes. No way. Jesus. It's queuing all the way past Cheveley Station services. Can't really show you because we're moving. Fuck. Newbie Bypass, north and south. They're fucking chock-a-block as well. Jesus Christ. I do have both hands on the steering wheel still. That's all the fucking queues. Holy moly, I need to make some phone calls. So I just made a couple of phone calls. Oh my God! They're saying 5 hours and 27 minutes. That's bullshit. Yeah, that's it. Back to 1 hour 22. We just went past a sign saying 50 minute delay. But I was on the phone, I wasn't recording. 50 minutes, the signs are saying. Mike's sat nav saying 1 hour and 22 minutes. Great. The joys of motorwaying. Fuck me. It could be anything. It could be an accident, or it could be just one of those fucking phantom crashes. You ever heard of phantom crashes? It's where someone brakes hard. Like, say they're coming along. Hang on, don't know how to do it. Say they're going along, they brake hard. As they brake hard, they then set off. The car here is still braked. It just goes back and back and back, if that makes sense. It's phantom crashes. So even though that first car's fucked off, because he braked hard, it's queued all the way back. There's a really good video about it, actually. I put on my Facebook page. Yeah, no, we're casually going, what, 8 mile an hour? Stopping and starting. And a sign saying 40 limit. Be lucky if you can get to 40, mate. Jesus. Yeah, so today we're off to Reading. We've got some sand on us. We have only got the one load to do. So I don't know what we're doing after that. I might be able to make a phone call and see if I can come back and get a second run, but I don't know yet. Otherwise I might have to call my boss and see if he wants me to go somewhere else. But we'll have to wait and see. They haven't ordered too much, to be honest with you. I am the second load to go. Someone else is ahead of me. And they've ordered 150 tonnes. So, and we carry 20 tonne each. I know there is at least two behind me. Three behind me. I know Mick's behind me. I know Chris is behind me. And I know Peter's behind me. and then me, and then Reg up in front. So that's five, so that's 100 tonne, which means there's only three more loads to do after that. But I also know that one of them behind me has got a second run to do, so I might be able to get back and do his run. I don't know yet. Never mind. I also know one of the guys behind me has got to do some tarmac later, and he's going to be stuck in traffic longer than me. Have to see. 1 hour 30 minutes, it's just refreshed. Bullshit. See, I came into work yesterday and I spent a good couple of hours cleaning the cab. I cable tidied the cables going up to the dash cams, so rather than just going across the dash, just both on the same side of the dash. Scrubbed the carpet, jet washed the mats, and I just done some general dusting. Nothing spectacular, but it was enough to make it look quite tidy, so I'm happy with that. It gets to a stage where it gets really dirty and you don't want to drive it, so I just got it nice and clean. Anyway, got some news to say. So far we raised £200 on the Just Given page. Thank you to everyone who's donated so far. Last night I spent some of it. It still shows £200 in the fundraising account, because that is still in the fundraising account. I spent my own money basically, which is going to be replenished when I get the cash from the funding. But basically I bought myself a 4K camera. It's not a GoPro, it's called an Apeman. I think it was $89.99. Shoots 20 frames per second in 4K, which to be honest I'm not really going to do. It does 1080p in 60 frames per second, which is pretty cool. And then it does 720 in 120 FPS as well. Basically it sounds like it's going to be really good. It's got 5-star reviews. It uses all the GoPro accessories as well. I bought more GoPro accessories. And what else did I buy? I got an SD card for it as well. Got some chargers for it. I'll make a video of everything I bought with your money. So hopefully I'll get all that in a week or so. And hopefully that camera, or this camera you're on now, I'm not sure yet, one of them will be on the back looking outside. So you see when I tip, which would be pretty cool. I've got to work out a way to attach it. I've got a bar on the right hand side, which I'm thinking about putting it on there, but I need some accessories so I can make the camera, because it's going to stick out like that. I need to turn it so it's like that, so you're the right way around. I also bought a flag. Someone mentioned that where's my flag gone in the comments section, and I had an old St. George flag, England flag in the back, and when I changed trucks I forgot to bring the flag out, and the truck has since been sold, so I don't have that flag. So I bought a new flag, but it's got my logo on it, so my logo will be set up at the back there, which is pretty cool. Someone said that would be a good idea. I cannot remember who it is, but I will find out and I'll put your name on the screen right now. So cheers buddy, I think I replied to you saying that's a cracking idea. In fact, I think a couple of people have said it. So that's good. I'll put your names up on the screen now. So yeah, bought that, and then I also bought a new hoodie with my logo on as well. I think it's on the left hand side. Can't remember what colour it was now. It's quite late at night I did this. So I spent nearly £200 of my own money buying this stuff. And when the crowdfunding page finishes or ends, I'll get that £200 back. So thank you everyone who's donated. Okay, so we just got out of the traffic jam now. Just went all of a sudden. It's now 20 to 9. So it wasn't too bad. It's 40 minutes, isn't it? I'm trying to think now in my head. 20 minutes. It's been 20 minutes. Oh God, there's another flashing sign. 20 minutes since I last spoke to you. And I was probably in a traffic jam for another 10 before that. So yeah, about half an hour queuing. But there's another sign here and another sign after that flashing. What does it say? Now they're passing. Queue on a slip road. Don't brake. I don't want to lose my momentum. I reckon I'm going to get the middle lane just in case. Just in case it's queuing onto this road as well. Really quiet at the moment. No, we look good. Back over. I just spotted one of our other drivers ahead of me. He must have left a good 10 minutes before me. Yet, I'm less than 30 seconds behind him. So it'd be quite cool if I can catch him up, overtake him on the hills. I'm a little bit more powerful than he is. He's in a slightly older truck. Got 12 miles left to go on the M4, and then we've got a bit of mileage to do going through Reading, so I'm hoping I can catch him up. It should be fun. Can't see him at the moment. Oh, there he is. Yeah, I see him now. Right, so we've caught up with him, as you can see. He's right in front of us. And we're also nearly here as well. Which is good. We're nearly there now, just around the corner. Been to Reading loads of times, I know vlogs while we've been here as well, so you probably know it just as well as I do now. I'm going to sneeze, hold on. Bless me. Because there's two lorries turned up at the same time, I might have to wait to tip, or you might get me to tip in a bay while he tips in the hopper, or vice versa. We will find out when we get there. Which is just around the corner. Right, I'm going to open the window. I'm not entirely sure what the sound is going to sound like with the window open. My microphone is here. I don't know if you can see. Hello! And in we go. Beacons on. Seatbelt off. What's he doing? Ah. That guy walking out now is the guy we want to sign our paperwork. There is, I don't know if you can see on the dash cam, on the left hand side there's a cement mixer truck in the way, so we can't get in yet. And not many people can get out over where we are. While we're waiting, I'm going to call the planners and see what else I can do. Call planning office. Hi Harry, it's Luke with DB61. All right, mate, yeah, just about to tip at Reading, but after that, I've got nothing else. Did you want me to go back and get more, or...? Yeah. That's all right. All right, mate, no worries. All right, bye, mate. There's nothing else on. He just got out straight into a puddle. Got that on dash cam as well. Do you see that? There's nothing else on, so when this is done, I gotta call my boss up and I'm probably gonna have to go somewhere I've never been to before, which is all fun and games. Right, we better get moving because it looks like it could be a busy day. Forgot I was empty then. Got away with a bit more acceleration than I was expecting. Right, so I called the boss. And we've got a long drive coming up, I think. Where we're going now isn't too long, it's only an hour and 15 minutes away from here. But I just looked at where he said I might have to, well, take it. He didn't actually give me a postcode of where to take it. He just said Hereford. Radbourne, Hereford. I just quickly googled it, and that's up somewhere towards Wales. From where I am, it's a 2-hour drive from where I am. And I'm going an hour the other way. So, if it is there, that's going to be a bloody good 6-hour drive. Obviously, you've got to take breaks and stuff. That's 6 hours there, and yeah, it could be a long drive, basically. So I'm trying to get a crack on, trying to move as quickly as I can, as safely as I can, because I've already done 2 hours driving. So we'll go get loaded. And then I'll ask for the postcode. And then we can crack on. And then have a break somewhere on the way. Come on, find your gear. So yeah, right now I've got to get in tarmac. I'm working out of a quarry, so it's going to be sand work. Don't mind doing it. I kind of enjoy doing it in a way because I get to learn new places. So I've never been to this quarry before. So it's going to be a new quarry under the belt to say that I've been to. And I've also never been to the place we're going to, I don't think. So it's all fun and games. Just going to be a lot of driving today, that's all. A lot of driving. Normally we do... Yeah, come on, dickhead, get in. Normally we do, like... no further than an hour's drive. We'll get in and out of the cab. I can show you more what's happening, but this vlog is going to be just driving, I think. Anyway, I'm going to crack on and I will see you in a bit. Right, yeah, I went left there. I actually need to go out, turn left, and then the next left. Sorted. Right. I turned left too quickly. The sat nav sent me down here, which is not actually the way to go. I just went on Google Maps, put it on Street View, so you can actually see the quarry. Not on Street View, but on satellite, that's what I meant. So you can actually see the quarry and then have a look at the road that goes in. I've left them a nice present on the grass. Only a little. Right, let's try again. Fuck me. At least I could turn around, that's the good. I was going back to reverse out onto the main road here. Which is, looks like quite a sharp left. I'm going to be probably on the other side of the road here. put my diff lock on so I don't spin as much. Right. And then we want the next left, I believe. Hopefully there's a sign or something saying Grindham's. Whee! Grindham, Grooms. No access for trade. That is me then, for future reference. And I got room to stop here as well. Like I said, I was hoping it'd be a double road in. Right, now we're off the road, take the seatbelt back off. Clear the routes. Drivers, do not clean out vehicles in lay-by. Drivers, use litter bins. It's a bit contradictive. I think I got a good 3 hour drive to where we got to go to next. Nice lay-by there, look, for me to stop in a sec. Groom's just left. Weybridge is there. You're going to want to go on the Weybridge. Right. I'm going to take the mic off. And I will be right back. Down the ramp, swing left, he said. I think it's down here. Right, I can't talk for long because I've got to get a fucking move on, and I can't put my GoPro on my thing up here because it needs charging and I ain't got long left. Basically, I got to drive 155 miles, which is going to take me 3 hours and 17 minutes, according to this. 155 miles, 3 hours, 17 minutes, and this is the route, plus all the other destinations I go to. There I am down there. Got to go all the way past the fucking my house and our yard, all the way up here to Hereford, which is like pretty much not far into Wales, if you like. So yeah, I got a long drive. ETA there is 2:40, and I need to have a break, and I got to get back. So late night. But yeah, I'll come back in a second when this is charged up. I'll do a bit more talking. So I'll see you on the other side. Right, hello guys. We are back on the road. I've just had my break. Had a 45 minute break at Membury Services on the M4, which is where we are now, on the M4. We've got 86 miles to go. We did have 155 miles, so I've done, what's that? 95, 50, about 60 miles, something like that. I can't think right now. I've done about 60 miles so far. 60, yeah, I think 60. And I've had a 45 minute break, so it's been a good 2 hours since I last vlogged. So that's all good. 85 miles left to go, 1 hour and 45 minutes worth of driving. Sat nav saying I will be there at quarter to four. So a lot of driving is still required.
It's not too bad though, because most of the journey I know, half the journey I know, we're actually heading back into Swindon. We've got to go past Swindon on the A419, down to Gloucester, past Gloucester, down Birdlip Hill, onto the M5, up to Tewkesbury. I know all my way up to there, and then after that is a bit, I'm not 100% sure how to get there from there. But I've got to go onto the M50 and then get onto the A49. I know that. I also looked on Google Maps while I was on my break, and it looks like it looks really easy to find, so that's good. Shouldn't have a problem like I had earlier, going down wrong lanes or anything. The only issue I might have is I got to weigh in first before I tip, and I couldn't see where the weighbridge was, so I got to try and find the weighbridge when I get there. And then I've got to come back. So I've got an hour and 45 minutes drive there. Probably about an hour drive back, maybe an hour and a half, 15, well, say an hour and 15 minutes. So I've got, at the very least, I've got another 3 hours of driving to do, at the very least. And I've got to be careful because I can only do another 4.5 hours driving before I need another break. So I got a bit of leeway, got 90 minutes leeway, so that's not too bad, not too bad. If anyone wants to know where I'm driving from and where I'm driving to, the postcode of where I got loaded was GU350QR, and the postcode I've got to go to is HR26JH. In fact, I'll include a picture on your screen now of the Google Maps, although bear in mind the route it's showing you is probably for cars going down type B roads and stuff, whereas I got to take main roads all the way there, which was up onto the M3, then onto the M4, which I'm coming off now, onto the A419, onto the A417, down Birdlip Hill, onto the M5. So this journey, I've gone on the M3, the M4, and the M5. No. Yes. And the M50 as well. Is it 50 or M40? I'm going on four different motorways. So that's quite good. That's going to be the title of this video, actually. M3, M4, M5 and M50 all in one day. Is it the M50 or M40? No, M40 is Banbury, isn't it? I think it's the M50. Ba-ba-ba. Let's have a quick lookage. There we go. That is the M50. Yeah. M40 is Banbury Way and Oxford. So, M3, M4, M5 and M50. All on one journey. So that's a new for me. I haven't done that many motorways. Fuck me, that's a bit bouncy there, isn't it? Jesus! Right. I will see you in a bit. It's going to be dark probably when we get there, so I do apologise for the lack of light. I'll have my inside light on. I am not overspeeding. Don't flash me up saying overspeed. I'm in a bit of a rush, as you might be able to tell. Although I am driving sensibly, I might have done 57 miles an hour. Never mind. Right, so can't remember how many miles we were at when I last spoke to you. Genuinely can't remember. Got 3 more miles left. Just got to turn right at this roundabout. It's been mainly motorways and A roads all the way here. As I've already mentioned, I was on the M3, M4, M5 and M50, and a fuckload of A-road as well in between. This, what I'm about to go on, is the first B-road. I can see a truck going down there, so it can't be too bad. That's good. So yeah, it's 155 miles. I'm about to stop and have a break on the way as well. 3 miles left. We were loaded 2 o'clock, and the time, no, we weren't loaded at 2 o'clock. Can't even remember what time we were loaded. It says on the ticket maybe it was 12 o'clock. We were loaded at 11 o'clock. Loaded at 11 o'clock, and now it is nearly 4 o'clock, so it's taken a good 5 hours to get here. And we've had to have a break in between as well. So, all good, it's all gravy. But I swear, man, like, doing long shifts like today, it just doesn't feel like it, because you're just chilled out, you're listening to music on the way down, you're having a sing song.
What's he doing?
Yawning now for some reason, but I'm not actually tired. We'll be glad to get home though. I probably won't be editing this video tonight. Like to, but I don't know, depends on when I get home. Current ETA is going to be about 5:30, 6 o'clock back into the yard. We started at 6:30. So we're talking an 11-hour shift, 11 and a half hours. But it doesn't feel like it. Doesn't feel like it at all. Charged the GoPro back up while I was on my break, it was on charge. And then I just done a little bit of recording when we left the services, didn't I? We're on the M4. So that's quite a few miles ago. Over 60, 70 miles ago. Roundabout coming up. Yeah, so as I mentioned earlier on in the video, I've spent a bit of your money that you guys have donated. So I've got another camera on the way. I could have waited until the money was put into my account, but I want to get better content out ASAP. So as soon as that camera comes, I'll be mounting either that one, the new one, or the one you're watching me on now. One of them will be mounted to the back, so you can see when I'm tipping as well. It should be absolutely amazing. But I'm open anyway. Right, so we are here. It's one of these places. We are looking for what are we looking for? Radbourne's. Radbourne's. I looked on Google Maps before I come here, so I know roughly where it is. I'm not 100% sure how to get in. Should be on the right. This yard here on the right. Yeah, Radbourne's entrance left. I think that means down here. Radbourne's. Now, I've got to try and find a weighbridge. Ah, there it is. So I'm going to go straight onto the weighbridge. Fucking tight. Oh, shit. Go on, mate.
Way on the road. Take your ticket to the office, boy.
Very tight there. I did just hit that cone. Destroyed it. It's very tight in. Right, he said just wait on the road and take the ticket in. So that is what I'm going to do. So I will be right back. Right, I'm back. Won't bother with the seatbelt just yet. Right, so I got my ticket signed. All I've got to do now is wait for someone to call me in. Which hopefully won't take too long. But hopefully long enough. He's calling me in now. So I say hopefully long enough so I can do some paperwork, but it doesn't look like it's going to be that long.
Catch him on that side, mate.
Yeah, where do you want me?
The bay's just over there, it is. Next to the brown sand.
All right, so I need to turn it in that way, yeah?
Yeah.
Basically, I need to go to the left, but the guy was on the right-hand side, reversing me in. So I got the complete wrong angle.
You're going in that bay, you need to face the other way.
Yeah, I'm going in that bay there, aren't I?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm going to face over there.
Yeah, but the bay's facing that way.
Right, let me have a look. I've not been to this site before. One sec. But well, these guys are assholes. Why the fuck are they telling me to reverse it when they want me to drive it? Look like you're a shit driver because you can't get in first time when they're actually telling me to reverse in the first place. Easier to drive in the first place.
Hey.
Would have been easier to drive in the first place, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, do you want me to go out and reverse out or spin down in the other?
Just drive up there and then I'll watch you go back, mate.
Okay. Yeah, they're making it look like I'm in the rubbish driver here. Except the way you're going, you're not going to get it in. Why don't you just fucking tell me to get it right in the first place? Right, let me close the tailgate up and I'll be right back. Right, my tailgate isn't closing properly, so I've got to try and close it. I'll take you with me, but I need two hands. So I'll be as quick as I can. Right, finally done.
Let's Foxtrot Oscar. That's army code for fuck off. Wheat. One hour, 40 minutes to get back. A lot longer than what I was expecting. Oh God, 76 miles back, really? Never mind. So that was a pain in the ass. Like, I found the place easy enough. I didn't want to go in straight away because someone said you have to go onto the weighbridge. And then I saw a weighbridge and attempted to get on it. Quickly realised I'm too big for that weighbridge. Nearly took out a wall at the same time. reversed back out. And then they called me in, but they reversed me in and then said I'm going about it the wrong way, that I need to be driving in. That's why I said, well, why didn't you drive me in the first place? Instead of making me look like a dickhead that can't drive. Then my tailgate wouldn't close, so I looked completely unprofessional. Completely unprofessional, like it was my first day on the job. Nothing was going right there. And now, on top of the 155 miles it took to get here, I got to do another 75 miles back to the yard. ETA back to the yard is 20 to 6, so I did say about 5, didn't I? But I expect I can make up a bit of time on these A roads. So yeah, I mean, next time you'll see me, I'm going to be in the yard and probably getting tired. So see you in a sec. Right, well, after that long shift and long day today, we are literally 3 miles away from the yard. We are just about to come off the A419 on the dual carriageway and go through Cricklade Town. I realise you can't see me at the moment. Let me just wait until I get off the dual carriageway and I'll turn my lights on a bit so you can see me. Because obviously I'm a beautiful person and you want to see my face, so. It's been a lot of driving today. And a lot of driving. In terms of driving, I've done about 8 hours worth, nearly 8 hours driving. Probably about 7.5, to be honest. I'll do a printout when I get back to the yard. Done about 7.5 hours driving. Close to 8, and I probably driven about 400 miles. Again, I'll do a printout when I get back to the yard, and I'll be putting it on Facebook tonight. Right, let's turn the light on. Hopefully you can see me a bit easier now. In fact, I've also got a head torch which I'm gonna shine over here a little bit. It's not in my face, it's more over there. You'll be seeing me a bit easier. Yeah, been a long old day today. I've got a text for tomorrow as well coming through, and I've got to do a similar day tomorrow. But, I mean, I've got to go to Redden first thing in the morning and drop off sand. But the key thing is I've got to come back and do another job.
So I won't be in Reading when I call my boss asking for more work. I will be around the area I'm in now, Swindon. So hopefully I haven't got to drive quite as far tomorrow. But yeah, it's been quite an interesting day today. A lot of driving and a lot of miles driven. Normally on a typical day there's a lot of sort of waiting around, but instead there's been a lot of driving and a lot of miles. Oh, a lot of hours as well. We're looking at 11 hour shift today. But like I mentioned earlier, for me, when I worked at Currys PC World and I would do a measly 9 till 6 shift, that would fucking drag. Oh, all right, mate, yeah, you pull out. I mean, it's my right of way, but that's fine. Yeah, all these assholes want to come as well now. 9 till 6, 6, 7, 8, 9, that's a 9-hour shift. That would drag like hell, and you would get an hour break. It would absolutely drag. Whereas doing this, I can work for 11 hours, and they only have a 45-minute break. And it feels just as quick. Like, I feel like I could easily work another couple of hours, very, very easily. Legally I couldn't. Legally, if I were to continue driving, I can only drive another hour before needing another 45 minute break, and then I can only drive for another hour after that, because you can only drive 9 hours a day, can't you? Extended to 10, I think, and I've done close to 8 now. But yeah, no, I could drive another couple of hours easily and it wouldn't affect me. So that's good. You stay there, mate. You stay there. Thank you. So, yes. I'm looking forward to receiving my gifts through the post. Why is she shaking her head? That woman was shaking her head. Looking forward to receiving my gifts, which you guys have bought me. So, thank you very much for them. Hopefully, the camera will be through. Hopefully, everything will be here by Monday next week. And my aim is to continue or start using it as soon as possible. So I've got a 4K camera coming, which will record 1080, well, record 4K obviously, but I won't be using it for that. It's going to record 1080p and 60 frames per second. So it'll be nice and smooth, as long as I render in 60 frames per second, that is. Yeah, they want to go, I can't go yet. Bought some more accessories for them to be mounted on. I bought a battery charger so I can charge the battery up quickly. Got a new hoodie which I can wear, which is going to promote the channel while I'm out and about of the cab. And I got a flag in the background as well, so it's going to be quite cool. Feel free to come through, mate. That's fine. You're welcome. So yeah, it'd be quite cool having the flag in the background. I can't remember who said get the flag. But your name's on your screen. If it ain't on the screen now, it'd be in the description, or it was on the screen earlier. But yeah, it's a cracking idea, and because of you, I went ahead and go and bought it. I think it cost about 30 quid for that flag. So yeah, happy days. So thank you everyone. I can't get my words out today. Perhaps I do need to finish work. Thank you to everybody who has watched this video. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for liking, and if you haven't donated already, hit this link on the screen now, link in the description as well, and go and donate to my channel, because it does help the channel out immensely, and I do spend the money, or I have spent the money so far, on buying new equipment for the vlogs. So yeah, go ahead and donate if you can. And that's it for me. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, drive safe.